गुड आफ्टरनून डियर स्टूडेंट्स. प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टार्टेड डिस्कस अबाउट एंड वी नो अबाउट गौतम बुद्ध एंड हिज टीचिंग्स. नाउ टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट उपनिषद्स. See, around the time that the Buddha was preaching, and perhaps a little earlier, other thinkers also tried to find answers to difficult questions. I hope you all have heard about the word Upanishad. So, all of you heard about, but of course we may not read, we may not studied, but we know, we heard about the Upanishads. See here, at the time of Buddha was preaching, and perhaps a little earlier only, the other thinkers also, so they were trying to find answers to difficult questions. Difficult questions. Okay. See, some of them wanted to know about life after death. Savina nantara yenu annadra bagge tilkollik anteli bahalashtu ondu vidvansarige kutuhala irutte. Of course, ನಮಗಾದರೂ ಆ ಕುತೂಹಲ ಇದೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಜನ್ಮದ ನಂತರ ಮುಂದೆ ಏನು, ಅಥವಾ ನಾವು ಹುಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಮುಂದೊಂದು ದಿನ ನಾವು ಸಾಯ್ತೀವಿ ನಂತರದ ಹೇಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸಿ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ದೇ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಡ್ಯಾತ್. ಸೊ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ನೋ ವೈ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ರಿಫೈಸಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಗಾಡ್ ಆಫ್ ನೋಸ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಅಪ್ಪರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್, so they were performed a lot of religious rituals, sacrifice and so on so forth. So they wanted to know that why sacrifices should be performed, yak madbeku adanna. So see, these are the questions. It's too difficult questions, it's not possible to get the clear answer also. So many of these thinkers felt that there was something permanent in the universe. There was something permanent in the universe that would last even after death. That would last even after death. So they described this as the Atman. The ಆತ್ಮನ್ ಅಥವಾ ನವೇನ್ ಆತ್ಮ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತೀವಲ್ಲ ಮಕ್ಕಳ, ಸೊ ಅದು ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇ, ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಡೇ, ಸೊ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಪರ್ಮನೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ವುಡ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇವನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಡೇ, ಇವನ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಮರಣದ ನಂತರ ಸಹ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾವಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಸಾಯುವಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ದಟ್ ಆಸ್ the Atman, or that is what called individual soul. Individual soul. See, Atma, that means individual soul, and there is the Brahman, not Brahman. Brahman is different, it is a Brahman. Brahma. So Atma is an individual soul. Atma is individual soul, and the Brahman, that is actually the universal soul.
universal soul.
See, they believed that ultimately both the Atman and the Brahman were one at home.
So they believed that both the Atman and Brahman, the individual soul and
universal soul were one only. So kone ella atmagalu so
Brahmanalli athwa universal soul enide alla Brahman alli leena aagtave
avereddu saha onte anna ondu nambike saha avarige. They believed that both the Atman and Brahman, so both were only one only. See, many of their ideas were recorded in the Upanishads. Many of their ideas. So these were actually part of the later Vedic texts. So these were composed, or these were at later Vedic texts. Upanishads. What is the meaning of Upanishad? Upanishad andre yenu? So literally meaning of the Upanishad, that is approaching. Upanishad andre, that is approaching. Getting dear students, Upanishad antheladre, that is approaching and sitting near.
Approaching and sitting near. So this is what the literally meaning of Upanishad.
Got it, dear students? So this is what the literally meaning of Upanishad. That means approaching and sitting near. Approaching and sitting near. See, the texts contain conversations between teachers and students. Here, war approaching and war sitting near. So it is actually the conversation between teachers and students. Guru matte shishyara nadivina samvada. Ile approach madavaru idare. ಮತ್ತೆ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಕಾನ್ವರ್ಜೇಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಆಫನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೆಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಡೈಲಾಗ್ಸ್. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಡೈಲಾಗ್ಸ್. ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ಥಿಂಕರ್ಸ್, most of the Upanishadic thinkers, so they were men.
So the most of the Upanishadic thinkers, so they were men.
Can you guess anybody? So these were belongs to maybe which class of the society? So there was no doubt. Yes. So the most of the Upanishadic thinkers were men. Especially they were Brahmins and Rajas. Most of them men, and they were Brahmins and Rajas. See, occasionally there is mention of women thinkers also. So there were women thinkers also, such as I think you have heard about some of the Upanishadic thinkers. So the women, such as Gargi. She was one of the greatest Upanishadic thinker during the time. So was famous for her learning and participated in debates held in royal courts also. Poor people rarely took part in these discussions. Again, the same thing, it was repeated, dear students. So during this time also, the debate and the discussion, whatever it may be, which were held in royal courts or in a common assemblies. So here, the presence of the poor class people, it's a very less. So they were rarely participated in these discussions. They took part rarely, the poor class people. We often said who were the poor class people? Those who are considered as in the society as lower class people. Lower class people. So they were actually rarely took part in these discussions. So one of the famous exceptions in this case was Satyakama Jabala. So it is one of the famous exceptions. In this case, was that Satyakama Jabala. So Garbhishi was a woman and Satyakama Jabala. See, Satyakama Jabala was named after his mother. The slave woman Jabali. So Jabali was a mother of Satyakama. Jabali, she was one of the slave women. Getting now. He had a deep desire to learn about reality. So in the rare case, the common people, the poor class people, so they were took part in this debate and discussions. So one of the case, so the Satyakama Jabala. Satyakama Jabala was a son of one of the slave woman Jabali, who she wants belongs to slave. See, he had a deep desire to learn about reality. Was accepted as a student by a Brahmin teacher named Gautama. So Jabali, I mean the Satyakama Jabala, he was accepted as a student by one of the Brahmin teacher who was named Gautama. I think he was a great person. Ekandre, he was accepted to teach to the poor or to the lower class, those who are from. And he became one of the best known thinkers of that time. So Gautama was one of the best known thinkers of that time. Was accepted as a student Satyakama Jabala. This is really the great, because he was accepted now. See, many of the ideas of the Upanishads were later developed by the famous thinker Shankaracharya. So about Shankaracharya, we are going to learn in the 7th standard. Okay. So nimage gottide makkala, Shankaracharya, Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya anthedi. So Mahan Santaru. So ee ondu Upanishad enidara, the ideas of the Upanishads. So that were developed by the famous thinker Shankaracharya afterwards. Got it, dear students? I hope so. So there were 6 schools of Indian philosophy. So Bharatiya Tattva Shastra Dali Makla. So aru ondu school antheledre, not in the present, what we called the group. Tattva Shastra Dali. Tattva Shastra Dali. So over centuries, India's intellectual exploration of truth has come to be represented by 6 systems of a philosophy. Bharatada bhaudika avandu enidiyala, so ee aaru ondu tattva shastragala mukantara adanna prachara kastu. They are known as vaisheshika, nyaya, samyakya, yoga, purva mimamsa, vedanta or uttara mimamsa. So these were the 6 different schools of Indian philosophy, such as Vaisheshika, Nyaya, Samyakya, Yoga Purva Mimamsa, Nyaya, Vedanta or Uttara Mimamsa. So these are the 6 schools of Indian philosophy. Just for your knowledge. See, these 6 systems of philosophy are said to have been founded by sages. Konada, Gautama, Kapila, Patanjali, Jaimini and Vyasa. So, ಈ ಆರು ಒಂದು ತತ್ವಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಗಳು ಏನಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಇವು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸೇಜಸ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಅವರು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಸೊ ಯಾರ್ಯಾರು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಕೊನಾದ, ಗೌತಮ, ಕಪಿಲ, ಪತಂಜಲಿ, ಜೈಮಿನಿ ಅಂಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಸ. ಸಿ ದೀಸ್ ಫಿಲಾಸಫೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಗೈಡ್ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ. ಜರ್ಮನ್ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ Indologist Frederick Max Muller has observed that the six systems of philosophy were developed over many generations with contributions made by individual thinkers. However, today we find an underlying harmony in their understanding of truth, although they seem distinct from each other also. So it is a So this is just for your knowledge purpose, just keep it in your mind. So there are six Indian schools of philosophy which were actually founded by the different sages. Getting this, please. Now I would like to tell something about Panini. I think all of you heard about the Panini, who as the famous grammarian of our country during this period. Understood now? So here actually the Panini, who was prepared a grammar for Sanskrit. Panini was prepared a grammar for Sanskrit, and he was arranged the vowels or the consonants in a special order, and then used these to create formulate like those found in algebra. He was one of the famous grammarian. He used these to write down the rules of the language in short formulate, around 3000 of them. Getting dear students, so Panini was one of the famous grammarian during this period. Understood? So who prepared a grammar for Sanskrit language, and also dear students, he arranged the vowels and consonants in a special order, and then used these to create a formulate like those found in algebra. So use this to write down the rules of the language in short formula, around about 3000 of them. Getting dear students. Now let us discuss about Jainism. See, dear students, all of you heard about the one of the most famous religion, that is about Jainism. See, the word Jaina, it comes from the term Jina. Understood now? The word Jaina, it comes from Jina. What is the meaning of Jina? Jina means conqueror. Jina means conqueror. What is the meaning of conqueror? Jaya. Get the word. Andre, yellavanna jayisidavanu. Pratiyondannu. Yellavanna means whether physically, if the person who conquered the entire world or regions or provinces, so for them, no. So agidre innenu ellavannu ulidellavanna manushana aase aakankshegalu atana pralobhanegalu mada matsara kama sorn so things yenella idiyala makkala ee ellavanna geddavanna jina anta karitara jaina anta heli karitara. That means conqueror. Now, let us discuss about Jainism. See, We all of you knows that Vardhamana Mahavira.
Vardhamana Mahavira.
See, Vardhamana Mahavira
was well known as
the 24th Tirthankara of the Jainas.
24th Tirthankara.
Get into your students. 24th Tirthankara. So, Vardhaman Mahavira, he was the last and 24th Tirthankara of the Jainas tradition. So he was also spread his message around this time, that is 2500 years ago. See, he was a Kshatriya prince of the Lichchavis.
Was belongs to Kshatriya, was one of the princes. Kshatriya prince belongs to Lichchavi family.
Lichchavi family.
Getting these students.
See, the last and 24th Tirthankara of the Jainas understood. Vardhaman Mahavira was the last and 24th Tirthankara of the Jainas. So he was spread his message around this time, that is 2500 years ago. And he was a Kshatriya prince of the Lichchavis, a group that was part of the Vajji Sangha, that about Vajji, that already we studied in the last chapter. So about Mahavira and then the Jainism and about the preachings of Mahavira, that we are going to learn in the next class. Thank you. Have a nice day.